Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I want to welcome everybody for the last day of Ramadan Ready program, a four-day Ramadan series. And inshallah, today, alhamdulillah, we are honored to have Imam Dr. Rehabi Muhammad from the Masjid Al-Ansar in the Woodlands. His topic today will be how to increase your faith during Ramadan. With that, Sheikh, how are you doing today? How's your day been?
Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Sheikh Hussein, Jazakumullah khairan, and Ramadan Mubarak to you and your family, inshallah.
Ramadan Mubarak to you and your family and to all the Muslims around. With that, inshallah, whenever, Sheikh, whenever you're ready, inshallah, bismillah.
Jazakumullah khairan. Bismillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man walah. Brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all, inshallah. May Allah make it easy for us to perform Ramadan. May Allah Azza wa Jalla let us witness Ramadan and perform Siyam, Salah, Dua, Dhikr, Qiyam. And may Allah accept from us all our good deeds, Ya Rabbul Alameen. How to increase our Iman? So the question is, does the Iman increase or decrease? Or if I am just Muslim, I'm saying La ilaha illallah, I'm still need to work on this La ilaha illallah, I'm okay, Sheikh Hussein. So the scholar said, Iman yazid wa yanqus. Yes, Iman will be increased and will be decreased as well. Will be increased with a'mal al-salihah, with good deeds. And Iman, the faith, will be decreased by committing sins and mistakes. May Allah protect us and protect our Iman, Ya Rabbil Alameen. During Ramadan, as we mentioned earlier, Ramadan, subhanAllah, the great chance and great training to ourselves and to our hearts, to our habits, to change many things that we are not able to make it or to change it during the year. But during Ramadan, it is our chance. We need to take advantage of this blessed month. We need to work in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open all the gates of Jannah. And Allah will close all the gates of Na'am. How? It is physically will be closed. Physically, the hellfire will be closed. The Jannah will be opened. Or how? Some scholars, subhanAllah, they mentioned something very interesting in this hadith that إذا كان أول يوم من رمضان فإن الجنة تفتح أبوابها وإن النار تغلق أبوابها. How? They said, because of your good deeds, you will be, Allah will open for you the gates of Jannah. And because you avoid all haram stuff, Allah will close the door of Jahannam in front of you. So something interesting that it is in our hands. We need to work on it. Yes, al-Jannah tufattah, Allah will open the Jannah for us and Allah will close the hellfire, the doors of Nar because of our good deeds. May Allah increase us in good deeds, Ya Rabbil Alameen. وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدًى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَىٰ. Those who follow the footsteps of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, for those who receive the Hidayah, the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will increase their hidayah. Zadahum hudan wa atahum taqwa. Allah will increase them in huda, in guidance, and in taqwa, in righteousness. Liyazdadu imanan ma'a imaniya. So Allah will increase the believers in their iman, in their faith. What about Ramadan? Yes, in Ramadan, our iman will be increased. As-siyam itself, when you fast from from Fajr till sunset till Maghrib, it is itself great ibadah. And this is the greatest ibadah that we have. As-siyamu li wa ana ajzi bihi. This is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only thing Allah Jal mentioned, this is ibadat. He mentioned, this is for me and I will reward my servant upon it. Only siyam. Why? Because siyam has ikhlas, that sincerity you have in your heart toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find it in siyam. Some people, they might lose this ikhlas, this sincerity during salah or during hajj. You know, Shaykh was saying, one day one brother or one person, he went to hajj and came back. This funny story, but sometimes people, they act in this way, unfortunately. He went to hajj and he came an hour at our back home. They called Abu. Abu Ahmad, Abu Abdullah, Abu Sa'id. This is the culture. Some other countries, they call their names by their names, Ahmad, Sa'id. So his name was, for example, Abu Ahmad. So he came back after Hajj and he went to the grocery store because they used to have like their grocery things, they stuff, they food, and they pay off at the end of the month. But that person, Abu Ahmad, he didn't pay for the grocery for month, 2, 3, 4, 5 months or more. So the owner, when he saw Abu Ahmad came back, he told him, "Oh, my welcome back, mashallah, Hajj Mubarak, mashallah." And he told him, "Okay, open the your notebook. Let me see." And he said, the owner of the store, he said, "Alhamdulillah." So he came from Hajj and he want to pay everything. The month, few months, he didn't pay anything, but maybe he now repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, "Okay, what is my name? What is my page?" He said, "Okay, 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute." He opened that his notebook. He said, "This is your book." He said, "What is my name?" He said, "Here, see, your name is Abu Ahmad." He said, "Okay, now change my name. Say, Hajj Abu Ahmad, Hajji Abu Ahmad." "Now my name is Hajj Abu Ahmad." He said, "Okay, I will change it. What's next?" He said, "See you later." So sometimes we perform ibadah just part of culture, part of, but siyam, no, siyam for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you might break your fast anytime, anywhere, nobody can see you. But that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "As-siyam li," fasting is for me, and Allah will reward it. Siyam itself, good and enough, will train us how to have ikhlas, to do things for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To perform Hajj for the sake of Allah, not to call you Hajj Abu Ahmad, Hajj Hussein, Hajj Habib. to bring certificate from Mecca, I'm Hajji now. Did you perform? Yes, I perform Hajj. How many times? MashaAllah, I perform Hajj 2 or 3 times. Oh, may Allah accept. Do not mention that. Keep it between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salah, sometimes, yes, during Salah, some people, they don't maybe have enough ikhlas, enough sincerity. But for Siyam, we have ikhlas, inshaAllah. So let us have that niyyah. Ya Allah, accept my Ramadan for you, Ya Rabbil Alameen. This is for you, and accept it from me, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Siyam, number one. That will increase our iman. Number two, brothers and sisters, Qiyam Ramadan, practicing extra salah every day, training yourself to pray extra salah. This is also itself a great opportunity to have reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to increase your iman and your faith. During the year, we are required to pray extra salah, salatul qiyam, qiyamul layl, or salatul tahajjud before fajr or after isha, before we go to our bed. Usually we ask our students, our youth, we ask them, please do 2 rak'ah or 4 rak'ah before you go to your bed. And do not go to your bed without wudu. That will be like protection from shaitan. Always do wudu, always pray 2 rak'ah before you go to your bed. During Ramadan, every night we need to pray Taraweeh, Qiyamul Layl. Every night, for 30 nights, that will be enough for us to practice this habit. We take it as a habit every night. After Isha, we'll pray 8 rak'ah, 16 rak'ah, 20 rak'ah, whatever. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, he used to pray 100 rak'ah during Ramadan. And other righteous people, other earlier Muslims, they used to pray more than that. This is between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To increase your iman, to increase your faith during Ramadan, big opportunity for every one of us to perform salah with jama'ah. Inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta. Praying with jama'ah, with congregation, better than praying alone with yourself. By yourself, you will get one hasana. But with jama'ah, will take 25 or 27 hasanat. Practicing salat al-fajr, dhuhr, asr, maghrib, isha, with jama'ah, that will be great. If you are not able to pray 5 prayers every day with jama'ah, please do fajr and isha. Fajr, maghrib, isha. Dhuhr, asr, you might be at your work, at your school, at your university, at your college, no problem. But may Allah Jal accept from you and make that great at your scale, inshallah. But at least for fajr, nobody start his work at fajr. We pray Fajr at 6:30, 6:15. So please get ready, go to your masjid, pray with jama'ah, and from the masjid, go to your work, go to your school. Reprogram yourself, reprogram your life, make your lifestyle in this way, praying at Fajr, at masjid with jama'ah. Now for Ramadan, you are already will wake up before Fajr for suhoor. Because if you don't have that suhoor, you will be tired, entire your day. and you will say, oh, I have headache, I am thirsty, I'm hungry. So you will go to your suhoor. You will have your meal before Fajr. Don't go to your bed. Do not lose Fajr prayer after suhoor. Get ready for Salah. After suhoor, get ready for Salah. Go to your masjid and pray. These 30 days during Ramadan will create a new habit, new life, inshallah, for entire your year. And make that plan, make that niyyah, intention to make it as a habit for Isha and Taraweeh as well. To increase your faith during Ramadan, brothers and sisters, recite Quran al-Karim, as we mentioned earlier. To have khatam, whole Quran from the beginning to the end, with understanding, with ta'ammul, tafakkur, tadabbur, feel it. Feel I need to read this ayat, and I need to also to practice it in my life. The Sahaba, radiallahu anhu, companions, they used to recite Quran in different way. We are recite Quran, we are compete each other to recite who will complete or finish Quran Karim first. But Sahaba, radiallahu anhu, they would recite only 10 ayat. After they finish 10 ayat, they don't move to other ayat until they practice it, understanding it well, practicing it at their life. Then they move to other verses from Quran al-Karim. They focus on actions, on practicing it, more than reciting or memorizing. Now, alhamdulillah, things made it easy for us in our life, more mashallah, Quran teachers and many Quran Islamic centers and whatever. Now we need to put some attention to understanding. كِتَابٌ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ وَلِيَتَذَكَّرُوا الْأُولُو. This is for tadabbur. Allah just sent this Quran to understand it. This is message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should not receive message from your boss, from your manager, from your principal, from your from the owner of your company, and ignore it and do not give it attention. Even if that owner of that principal of that king or that president send you directly a message in different language, but you know this is came from him, this message came from him, I need to understand. So you go to people to help you how to understand this message. And if something in that message requests you to do something, you will do your best to do that. This is a message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah called us, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, 98 times in Quran al-Kareem. Allah called us, ya ayyuhal nas, in Quran. Allah called us, ya bani Adam. Allah called us, ya ayyuhal insan. So many times after he called us, we should respond. And Quran al-Kareem with each letter, hasana. Wal hasanatu bi ashri amthaliha, wallahu yudha'ifu liman yasha. Quran, during Ramadan, Ramadan is the month of Quran. Ramadan, the month of Quran. So we need to put more effort to spend time with Quran al-Kareem, with your family, with your children, with your spouse. And that will make your life easy. And that will help you to have peace, tranquility, tuma'nina, sakina at your home. Al-Shaytan will not stay at that home. Al-Shaytan yafirru min al-bayt alladhi yukhra'u fihi al-Quran. Shaytan will go far away from you, from your house, if you keep reciting Quran al-Kareem. Things to increase our iman and faith during Ramadan. MashaAllah, we started already now ISGH and through Brother Hussein, we started that halaqat, that MashaAllah, Majlis al-Ilm. Now we are in Majlis al-Ilm now. This kind of Majlis al-Ilm will increase our faith. طلب العلم وقل ربي زدني علما تفقه في الدين ومن يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. Asking scholars, asking imams about your religion, about your siyam, about your salah, about your zakah, about your deen, that will increase your faith. فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Attending majalis, attending halaqa, attending classes, that will help you to increase your iman. How to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how to love Allah without knowing Him? How you can practice Islam without learning fiqh, tafsir, hadith? How you will be able to follow the footsteps of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How you will be able to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam without knowing him, without study his life, without listening to the scholars about Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? هم القوم لا يشقى بهم جليسهم. If you stay with the good people, with the scholars, with the imams, Allah will grant you happiness and tawfiq. Allah will grant you more ilm and more knowledge. Brothers and sisters, increasing iman, increasing our faith during Ramadan, something very important to surround yourself with good friends. And we mentioned that earlier as well. How to get ready for Ramadan, to have good friends. Now also, increasing your faith, you need to avoid bad company, bad people. You need to stay away from shaitan and from the people of shaitan. We have people of Rahman, we have awliyaullah, and there are also people of shaitan. Always they are around us. Always they need to push us to do haram, to do bad stuff. We need to take care of these things. Do not listen to them. Do not look at them. Do not talk with them. Unless you have something to do for them, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you make sure they will change their habits. They will be good after your speech. Otherwise, do not waste your time. Take care of yourself. Protect your heart, protect your faith, protect your iman. May Allah Azza wa Jal increase us in iman. May Allah Azza wa Jal protect us from shaitan. Increasing iman and faith during Ramadan, avoid TV, avoid YouTube, avoid social media as much as you can. Unless you have specific channel, YouTube, specific people you are following them, specific imams or scholars, or good channels you are benefiting from them, that will be good. Otherwise, please, during Ramadan, off everything. Turn it off and stay away from these things that will push you away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Try during Ramadan. Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِهِ وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ وَكَانَ أَمْرُ فُرُطًا. Do not follow. Do not obey, do not stay with the one who went back from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, went away and committed many haram and sins. Stay away from these people. Stay away from them, those who are following their evil desires. They will push you to do haram and they will push you to go to Jahannam wa al-iyadhu billah ta'ala. May Allah protect us, ya Rabbil Alameen. During Ramadan, brothers and sisters, it is our opportunity to control ourselves, to control our tongue from ghiba and namima, backbiting, namima, talking against people, talking about brothers or sisters, talking about your friends. Please take care of yourself. Please take care of your heart. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect you. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you, to support you, to forgive you. Fix your issues first. Take care of your eye. Do not look at haram stuff. Lower your gaze from haram stuff. Look at Quran al-Kareem. Look at Quran al-Kareem. Look at the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look at the tafsir book. Use your time wisely. That will help you to increase your iman. So always ask yourself every day during Ramadan, what about my iman? Did I increase it today or not? What things I did? What things, good deeds I did or I commit haram or things? Let us do istighfar for haram stuff. Let us do istighfar for some sins we might committed during Ramadan. Yes, during Ramadan, shaitan will work hard to let you lose your reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the way, we can talk, inshallah, one day about shaitan will call you to good deed during Ramadan. How? It is like some details, we will learn it, to be aware from shaitan. Yes, shaitan sometimes will call you to do good deed, but you will leave maybe better or something great, greatest than that good deed. For example, shaitan will ask you to recite Quran at home. Okay, for 30 minutes. But at that time, there is jama'ah, there is qiyamul layl, there is isha and tarawih. So shaitan told you, okay, Sheikh Hussein, please stay and recite Quran Kareem, continue your recitation, mashallah, and you are getting benefit from your Quran. You think and you understand the ayat, read it. It is the book of Allah, this is the message of Allah. And Sheikh Rahabi said, Sheikh Rahabi talk about the message of Allah. Stay in now, and you are a little bit tired after, mashallah, after that biryani, halim, sambusa, and after that iftar. Stay home, drink some coffee, some tea, and read Quran. He is calling for good deed, but it is not time for this. It is time to pray Isha. It is time to pray Taraweeh now. For after Fajr or after Suhoor, okay, stay here, do istighfar, do dhikr, do dua, and rely a little bit, lay down a little bit, get some rest, take some rest, and you will be active, inshallah, to go to Fajr. Then you will fall in sleep until 8 o'clock. So shaitan sometimes, we have to be smart and we have to be wise enough to know how shaitan will come to our hearts during Ramadan. During Ramadan, we'll tell you, okay, now spend this charity, give this money for this cause, for example. But if you give it to other cause, maybe the people will get benefit more. For example, shaitan will tell you, okay, go and print out Quran Kareem, pay your charity, give, for example, this $1,000 to bring more copies of Quran Kareem and send it to this masjid. Every masjid has thousands of masahib, thousands of copies of Quran Kareem. But this 1,000, if you send it to your family members, if you look at your family in large or your community, you will find many people, they are in need. If you give them that money, they will get benefit from it. Which is better? To see, it is a little bit sensitive sometimes, and it is hard to distinguish between it is which is better. Shaitan will come to let you take hasanat less than other good deed. How can we know that? Ask your imams, ask your scholars, and think before you do anything. Always wasabiqul khayrat. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us from those people, those who listen and they obey. And Allahumma ja'alna mimman yastami'una al-qawl fayattabi'una ahsana. Allahumma ja'alna hudatan mahdiyyin, ghayra dhalin wa la mudillin. Allahumma taqabbal minna ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma a'inna 'ala as-siyam wal qiyam wa ghadd al-basar wa hifdh al-lisan. واجعلنا يا ربنا في هذا الشهر المبارك من عتقائك من النيران برحمتك يا حنان يا منان. اللهم أعد علينا رمضان أعواما عديدة وسنين مديدة وأنت راض عنا يا رب العالمين. يا الله bless us, bless our brothers and sisters. يا الله bless our families. يا الله bless our children. يا الله make us in this Ramadan people of Jannah يا رب العالمين. يا الله give us شفاعة of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم during this Ramadan. يا الله increase us in إيمان, in علم, in خير, in حكمة يا رب العالمين. يا الله increase us in إيمان. Ya Allah, protect us from shaitan. Ya Allah, protect us from shaitan. Ya Allah, protect us from our evil desires, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, Allahumma allimna ma yanfa'una wa anfa'na bima allamtana. Ya Allah, grant us beneficial knowledge, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Ya Allah, grant us beneficial knowledge. Ya Allah, grant us wisdom. Ya Allah, grant us your peace, your rahmah, your mercy, your tranquility, your forgiveness, your maghfira, Ya Rabbal Alameen. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك ولا تجعلنا من الغافلين سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير اللهم هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم افتح بخير واختم بخير واجعل عاقبة أمورنا إلى خير يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا غياث المستغيثين يا رجاء السائلين يا مجيب دعوة المضطرين يا رحمن الدنيا والآخرة ورحيمهما ارحمنا يا الله استرنا يا الله اغفر لنا يا الله تب علينا يا الله أكرمنا يا الله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد صلاة تشرح بها صدورنا وتيسر بها أمورنا وتغفر بها ذنوبنا مولانا رب العالمين اللهم اجعلنا بالصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد من الفائزين ولحوضه من الواردين الشاربين يا رب العالمين اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدنا ولمشايخنا ولمن له حق علينا والمسلمين اجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين
جزاك الله خير دكتور رهابي and it's been a great to have you this past few days and inshallah we look forward to benefiting from you that class that you mentioned inshallah we're definitely going to do very soon the tricks of shaitan into good rewards inshallah so it's been a pleasure to have you remember us in your dua inshallah and inshallah we'll see you soon
bi'iznillah ta'ala ramadan mubarak to you and all our brothers and sisters and all IGH family inshallah
take care sheikh assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah